That's the local boy Ray Cowan going around there on the outside. From Ross Snell. Then we've got Marshall Mott. And John Lloyd driving the number 3. So John, a little bit unfamiliar with this car. And if you're wondering why it's lagging at the rear of the field, it's just that Neville's not too well. The wet track's not really making much difference to Ray Cowan. He's punting the big Falcon around there pretty well. And of course, those that were here at our last meeting, Victorian title, I'm sure you will agree it was a slap-up weekend. Second and third place between two local drivers, Ross Snell and Marshall Mott. Second and third place between the locals. This is the limited sporties racing for you here. A bit of a false start here as Peter Worthy got as far as the judge and that was it. Nicely finished. So we've got six here just to start this off, and the reason why we've only got six is because you saw the first event, the track's a bit greasy, and just for a minor race, well, we don't want the boys coming in damage, so this time they're off and racing. Les Mutch, Hetherington and Greg Riley, Rob Tucker, McMaster and Robbie Arnell just finding their way steadily around the other side there. Into the groove out on the high line track. Hetherington leading Parnell in 28 and Don McMaster in the 88 car. Well, young Hetherington getting right away from them. To go there for a Hetherington. He's done this one easily. He's left the boys behind. Really has treated them. That's unusual, but obviously got the car fired up. And there's 76 taking the win. The car of Hetherington. Next round will be 69. Riley from Robbie Tucker, Robbie Arnell and Don McMaster. Right, we got the we'll get the time for you as quick as we can. That won the first round of the limited sporties, and 76 Rodney Hetherington took the win from 69 Les Much, and third was Greg Riley in 75. The lap time was 20.77, that was the fastest lap. And the race time was 207.23. Now, coming out onto the grid now is the first heat of Being Modified. And they're running for the top 9 point scorers. Darren Cockrell in the Vic 2 car, Sean Quayle in 27, and Dean Sparrow in Hamilton 8. Peter Bodger in the EH. All right, well, we've got a restart. Starter not happy with them. So line them up again, they must hold their line. Now we've only got 8 cars there, so they should be able to hold their line steadily enough as they come around. So we'll give them one more go. Craig Swanson, the pole car. Gardner up there in Mortlake. He's looking out a little bit wide. Neil Watson gets under him. Darren Cockrell trying to get under. Once he heads, Neil Watson heads out after Randy Gardner. And we've got a nice group of cars there holding it together pretty well. Gardner from Swanson. Cockrell, Watson, Burrows. Then we've got Sean Quayle, Bodger. Gardner trying to get away now from Watson, but Cockrell up there in third place. So as they come around to see the starter here, it's Gardner from Swanson, then Cockrell. Burrows in there from Neil Watson, Sean Quayle, Bodger, and Dean Sparrow bringing up the rear in the 8 car. Well, Cockrell out after Gardner there on the far side. Johnson back to third. So it's Gardner leads them around. From Cockrell, Swanson, Silva is in the 65 car. Watson, the 2EH is having a good battle there between Bodger and Pyle. Good finish coming up here too. Oh, it's have to be Cockrell. We'll just wait for the officials there, but Vic 2 gets the nod from 14. Well, that was a slashing finish, that was. And 15, the car of Craig Swanson, was third. Official placings there, but they were pretty clear cut. But we're back with Sportsman. Hey. Limited sport, he's coming around, so I'll try and pick them up. South Australians, I think, leading them around at this stage. Which would make it Simon Gardner. Oh, change that around. Ann Golding in 77, Don Golding in 7, Moldy Calderwood back in the little Mitsubishi Cub. 26, I think, is Davey Bruhart. Then we've got overall from Ballarat. They just tell me it's Sheila at Calderwood driving the little Mitsubishi. Sheila had a good run in the ladies' titles this year, winning both the Open and the Modified Production, so congratulations to Sheila, belatedly, but we did mention her before. And now she's up there driving it with the fellas in the little Mitsubishi Cup. Right, Sam Gianpoli on pole. Davey Bruhart's out there in the 26 car, as I said, Ann Golding in 77, Rod Stevenson going around out there in the 42 car, Don Golding in 7, Mark Bunting in the 72 car, and Sheila bringing up the rear in the little 13. Starting to spread out around the track again, it's Sam Gianpoli bringing it around. From Davey Bruhart, Rod Stevenson in 43, overall in 10, Don Golding up there in 7, Ann Golding in 77. Oh, and Sheila gives Mark Bunting a little bit of a get out of me road as she goes up the back straight, all right. Right, now they tell me. That is Moldy Calderwood driving Sam Gianpoli on. Thanks, fellas, for letting me know. We'll do it all over again. Moldy Calderwood up there in Sam Gianpoli's Commodore. Stevenson now, Lenny Ladner, sorry. Oh dear, oh dear. Lenny Ladner up there in the 43 car. We'll get it right before the night's out. Moldy Calderwood in 22. Then we've got Lenny Ladner there in 43. Davey Bruhart in 26. And Don Golding in 7. Overall in the 10 car. Ann Golding in 77. Bunting in 72. And Sheila Calderwood trying to get through there in the Mitsubishi Cold in 13 at the rear of the field. It's still Moldy Calderwood up there with the 22 car. One lap to go. Then Lenny Ladner. From Davey Bruhart. Don Golding in the 7. This overall there in 10. The girls have got the split on Mark Bunting, and it's Ann Golding, but Moldy Calderwood takes it through in 22 from 43. Then we've got 26, the car of Davey Bruhart from Don Golding. Chris overall there in the 10 car, and a good battle up the front here between Ann Golding in 77, Sheila Calderwood in Portland 13, Mark Bunting in 72. So my apologies there, but they didn't tell me about the change of drivers. And of course you'll see 42, I think it is, Stevenson's car coming out later on in the night. So a little bit of confusion there, but we'll get it right. The Sam Gianpoli car took the win from Lenny Ladner in 43, Davey Bruhart in 26th. Lap time was 20.76 and the race time was 2:05.81. This is the open sporty class, not to be confused with the limiters that we've just seen the two heats run. This is two heats and a final over 20 laps, and it's the open sporties. They run more carbies and wider tyres. That's the base difference between the two cars, and you should see some good times from these guys. They're off and racing. Thank you. cars going everywhere, a lot of smoke coming out of, I think that was Aston's car. But it's 19 Victor. Just have a look at that, fellas. Peter, in the centre there. You got a car there on fire? It's gone out by itself, nothing very serious, just a bit of flame. Right, well, what a, that was a pretty thrilling sort of a race, wasn't it? Hammond out with the Super Sedan and John Lloyd in Wimmera 5, Ray Hammond in 22, Marshall Mott in the RMM and R Crafts car. Should be a good race here between the two Rays. Ray Hammond in 88, Ray Hammond in 22, Marshall Mott in 89, John Lloyd in the 5 car. That's a Ross Snell bringing up the rear in 15. Well, battle of tactics up here between Ray Hammond and Ray Cowan. Marshall Mott from John Lloyd in 5 and Ross Snell there in the 15 car. Well, the two Rays out there having a good battle down the back straightaway into this corner. Ray Hammond, Ray Cowan. Then we've got Marshall Mott there in the M&R Crafts car from John Lloyd in 5 and Ross Snell in 15. That's Cowan looking for the run through on the inside. Hammond on the outside. Great, nice. Always get a great. There we go. Cowan looking for the run under the inside. Couldn't quite do it. Just one left to go. Hammond from Cowan. Thank you. to come third. You only need two top cars in this class and you get them out there and they'll put on a good driving duel, and that was a good exhibition over six laps. Non-contact driving, and that's what it's all about. Right, well, the officials there, Ray Hammond in 88, Ray Cowland in 22, and Marshall Mott in the M&R Crafts car in 89. The fastest lap was 18.19, and once again we missed the race time for the Super Sedans. Lang 22. Wimmera 15, Rod Berry had a new paint job, so looks quite good. Peter Dowling, the driving the HA12 car. So, long time since we've had Peter back in the B grade class. Laurie Wilson in 43, done a bit of repanelling, started to repanel the car. 33, the car of Mark Vaughan Olive. 47, Steve Ellis. 31, Damien Smith. And 77. Right, 10 cars to contest this event. And Golding on the coveted pole position beside Laurie Wilson. In 33, Ann Golding back there in 16 in third place. Peter Batten pushing up in 22. 31, Damien Smith. 15, Rod Berry. Steve Ellis there in the 45 car. 12 is Peter Dowling. And Robert G. Sellers bringing up the rear of the field. Well, spreading out around the track a little bit there now, but it's Laurie Wilson, the lead car, in the Regan's car of Fillmore there in 10. Laurie Wilson leads them around this time in 43. He's got it going pretty well. From Fillmore there in 10, Peter Batten is in the 22 car, and Ann Golding gets it sideways, gets a nudge off there from Peter Dowling. And Laurie Wilson in the 43 car, he leads them around. From Fillmore and Batten up there in 32, Rod Berry in 15, Damien Smith, 47, Peter Dowling. Golding from Sellers there, Robert Sellers there in the 77 car. Just one lap to go now for Laurie Wilson in 43. Car of Laurie Wilson first over the line. Then we've got Peter Batten in 22 and Fillmore in 10. Then we've got Rod Berry, Smith, Steve Ellis, Peter Dowling in the 12 car, Vaughan Olive in 33 and Ann Golding in 16. And Robert Sellers coming around to in the Farrell Engineering car. Well, Laurie Wilson took that one out in 43. 22, Peter Batten was second. And 10, Jeff Fillmore was third. The lap time was 20.17. And the race time was 2:02.44. Phil McAuliffe, Ballarat 4, Normie Fisher, Portland 7, Brian Hayden driving a new car. It's the new Commodore, looks very nice, very well prepared as Brian usually does. Mount Gambier 15, Snow Merritt. Mount Gambier 15, Stuart Merritt, the son of Snow Merritt. Just have a look at that 70 Portland 7 car of Brian Hayden going up there in the inside in third position. Jim English in 14. Well, A grade in the starters' hands. Nine cars, so I've missed one there somewhere. We've got an extra one in there somewhere. Leads them around in the Ballarat car. McAuliffe in there in 21, Hayden up there in the Portland 7 car, and that 11 car blowing a lot of smoke. Hayden going around the outside there in Portland 7. Then we've got Stephen there in the 42 car, and awful lot of smoke coming off that car. Look at Max Carl up there, just running in a brand new motor. This is what Max Carl's running in. He's up into third. Just picks his way through the field. Max Carlin up there from McAuliffe, 42 to Stevenson car, Merritt there in 14, Gardner in 17, Merritt in 15, Jim English bringing up the rear in the HA14, so not much between these front three. Max Carlin looking for somewhere to go, Normie Fisher in the 4 car, Carlin looking for a run around the outside of Hayden. Hayden gives Fisher a bit of a shunt there, and Jim English in HA14. Shirley with the first aid kit down to the pits. Shirley, with the kit to the pit box, please. Normie Fisher took it out in Ballarat 4. Max Carlin up there in Portland 12. And Brian Hayden in Portland 7-3rd. Thank you.
three front runners.
Scott's ball really whipped from there that time.
got them bowl ready. So I'll get an extra lap there. Two laps for a little bit. Just going to take them around and dry the track out a bit. So another rolling lap before we line them up. Roger on pole. Crossbar is outside. Bodger up there on pole, Sean Quayle, Peter Batten on outside in 22. We've got Craig Swanson and Kilmore, Laurie Wilson. Now we've got them bunched up. Peter Dowling moves up now and then going to my course right there, isn't it? Thank you. Patton in 20C. Takes the win from Burrows. And 10, the car of Fillmore was third. Interval. I don't think our speakers are working up the top end of the track, but someone can relay the message to the girls from the canteen that there will be interval after this event. We've got through them pretty quickly. In fact, it's only 8:45, but of course, the earlier we get finished, we've got some features lined up for you, some hectic races. Another open sporty heat for a look of it. But that will be after interval. Then we've got the Wimmera Zone Series. Wimmera Zone Series for A grade. Then we've got the Wool City Cup. Sportsman Classic. And then a consolation. So still a lot of racing. Are we ready? Yeah. So if you want some action from the modified title, just see Rex up there or see our secretary. We've got a car stalled at the gate. So we'll line them up again. We've got Ladner, Stevenson, Mark Bunning. We've got the Commodore. Carlin's out there. One of the merits. Jim English and McAuliffe, I think, is the other one. No, Norman Fisher. Right, well, we've got Stevenson on the pole there. We should. No, we've lost merit, I think. Lenny Ladner joins him. Happy to see Mouldy driving the game pole nomination. Much better line up this time with Stevenson and Ladner on pole. Thank you.
Coming together over there, but don't lose any places. So we've got 42 car, Pearson up there as well. Now we've got 45 and 23, which is Andy Bolt. One left to go for Scott Ball from Darren Clamp. Then we've got Terry Badger in 42. Pearson there in 12. 45 car, then Bolt in 23. And 47. Takes the win, 18, 36, 42. Darren Clement, 42, Terry Boucher. Lap time of 17.28 and the race time 2:21.3. Everywhere here, the B grade, Wimmera's Own Series, Watson the leader from Burrows, then Laurie Wilson, Philmore, Roger up there, then we've got Vaughan Olive, Steve Ellis, Sean Quayle, Dan Golding, Farrow, back of the lead car is Watson from Ross Burrows, then we've got Philmore, Wilson and Roger there in the EH. Watson from Burrows, then we've got Philmore, Roger, then we've got the Wilson car. So still Neil Watson from Ross Burrows, then we've got Jeff Philmore, Peter Bodger, Laurie Wilson, Steve Ellis, then we've got Ann Golding working her way through the field from Sean Quayle. Then we've got Dean Sparrow, Peter Dowling and Vaughan Olive from Robert Seller there in the 77 car. Peter Bodger, he's in fourth, from Laurie Wilson, Steve Ellis, Anne Golding, Sean Wild, Peter Dowling, Sparrow and Vaughan Ollis. Spread around the track now.
still wants the leader from Burrows. Then we've got Jeff Kilmore, Peter Bodge is still in there from Laurie Wilson. Steve Ellis then. Just with one left to go, it's Neil Watson in the 40 car. From Rossborough it's 65, then we've got Kilmore in the 10 car. From Wilson in 43. Steve Ellis, then Ann Golding in 16. From Sean Twyle. Over the line, no, we must have them very shortly. Here it is. Neil Watson in the 40 car from Burrows in 65. Then we've got Bill Moore in 10 and Roger in the EH in his 10 from Laurie Wilson. Then we've got Steve Ellis and Ann Golding. Then Sean Quayle, Peter Darling and Dean Sparrow. Bunting on the outside. Stevenson coming up there on the other outside car. For the A-grade zone series. Happy with the start. Up there in the 14 car, Bunting in 72, Brian Hayden pushing under there in 72, in the 7 car. Then we've got Max Carlin. Scarter is in the 17 car. So Gartner. Sacramento there in 17. From Portland 7, the car of Hayden. And Portland 12, Max Carlin. The race time over the 8 laps was 2:33.12. And the fastest lap was 18:67. Makes it a line of three around the back straight away, and Hammond in all sorts of trouble. Gets blocked. Cowan makes the run now. Hammond's out after him. Then Marshall Mott, John Lloyd, and Rod Snell. The Ray Cowan, the lead car. From Ray Hammond. Then we've got Marshall Mott, John Lloyd pushing up on the inside of him. Takes the lead from Marshall Mott and Rossell. Goodyear out in front. It's Ray Cowan and Ray Hammond. The two V8s. John Lloyd in the Capri from Ross Snell and Marshall Mott. Coming around for the finish. And it's Cowan from Hammond. there's no doubt about this, it's certainly going to be interesting. The Wall City Cup in half light down there in the back straight away. The drivers will be easing off, looking where to go. But they're all, we've got a problem. No, he's out of the road. Well, that was certainly good luck. So they're off and going now and settling down. One lap down. And Carl on the lead car from Cockrell. Then we've got Peter Batch, Laurie Wilson, Danny Gardner, Don Golding, McCaleb and Craig Swanson up there. And we've got Pillmore into the fence down the bottom.
Then we've got Darren Cockrell in third place. We've got Peter Batten and Andy Gardner.
Don Golding, Laurie Wilson, Tommy Fisher making a move there, and Merrick, Stevenson, Hayden, Michaela Swanson and Damien Smith at the rear of the field. This is Carlin around once again. And Moldy Golder was sort of driving around on the inside of the field. Cockrell's up in second place from Moldy Golder was in Peter Batt. We've got Eddie Gardner, he's all crossed up there on the top fence. There's a charger car there, it's Cockrell up in second place from Carlin. Carlin's got a pretty big gap. Like Andy Gardner Golden today. It's still Carlin now, he's got cars in front of him from Cockrell. Peter Batten up in third from Molly Calderwood. Then we're back to Don Golding, Norby Fisher, Laurie Wilson, Snowmer, Stevenson. And Brian Hayden calls it a day. Michaela Swanson as Carlin comes up again. Cockrell here in the two car. Then we've got Peter Batt from Ian Calderwood. Ten Ford comes out from Carlin. Now we've got three left cars. Michaela starting to boil. Now we're back to Cockrell. Peter Batt, Moldy Calderwood. Then we've got Norby Fisher. Easy now. Carl on the lead car. Hey, no. It looks like there's only one left to go. From 22 and 22, Norby Fisher in 4. 7, 42 and 14. And it's all over. 20 laps non-stop and they did it pretty well. Another win to Carlin. And I think they drove very well there considering that they had to put up with that half light. But the lights are all on now. And to run 20 laps non-stop, they've done it well.
Thank you.
18.34. The fastest race time was 6:14.14. Open 40's going now. Classic for 1990 here at Western Speedway, the big one, over 15 laps. Scott Ball in 18, Terry Badger 32, Peter Pearson up there in the 12 car. They're the front three runners as they go around here in the Open Sporty Classic. Scott Ball in 18. Rogers in 45. They're the front runners as they go around. Rogers in 45. We've got Bulk up there in 23, and then we've got the 44 car. We seem to have run out of cars rather quickly. 36 Darren Clem. Scott Ball round again in the 18 car. From Terry Boucher, Peter Pearson up there, then John Rogers, Bolt, and 44 being the car of Ron Andrews. Ten laps to go for Scott Ball. Just where he is. Pearson passes him up the straightaway. Once again, it's full from back here. Then we've got Pearson's 12 car. Swims in there in 36. Just two laps to go. And Barry's in trouble. Just one left to go for John Ball in 18. Then we've got 42 Jerry Boucher. The car of Pearson. He's running third, I think. From 36. There's the finishing line coming around. 18. Terry Boucher in second place, and he was hard on Scott Ball's trail, but he was just picking him up. And I think, as I said, I think car 12 is the third car across the line from Darren Klim. So give them a big hand, they come around, ladies and gentlemen, another 15 laps non-stop here at Western Speedway. This track's in pretty good shape tonight. Well, we've got a consolation and then we've got a limited sporting feature over 15 laps to come right up. So there's Scott Ball taking the flag around, give him a big hand. Okay. And another lap record to this young fella. I thought they were going around pretty good, but 16.97. Fantastic time, 16.97. So another lap record. Carlin first, Vic 2, Darren Cockrell second, and third Peter Batten from Lang in Lang 22. The A grade division, Portland 12 first, Portland 22, Mouldy Calderwood second, and Ballarat 4, Normie Fisher third. And in the B grade division, Vic 2, Darren Cockrell first, Lang 22, Peter Batten second, and HA 43 third. In the Open Sporty Classic, a great race it was too. 18, Scott Ball blitz the field there to take that one out. Terry Boucher hard on his heels, and 12, Peter Pearson in third place. A new lap time record of 16.97. And that was set back in 1, 2, 3, 4. The fifth lap, 16.97. He was really on fire then. And turned in some crackers. The rest were all in the 17s. So he's really turning it on here at Western Speedway. And the race time was 4.85. No. 4.25.65. And of course, that was only over 15 laps. So. Right, well now we're running the consolation over 10 laps for the non-starters. Sheila Colwell up there on in the little Mitsubishi Cult following Neil Watson around. That was certainly strange for Neil Watson not to qualify. But Wobby leads them around now from Sheila Calderwood. Ann Golding in 77. Dean Sparrow's up there in 80. He's done a good job to get through the field. Mark Bunting in the 72 car. And I think we've got it'd be Steve Ellis. But Neil Watson's clearing away here in B grade. Yeah. there. Notice the tail up around there as they go down the back straightaway. And Peter Dowling has a spin and certainly lucky that he never collected any, or nobody collected him, I suppose you'd say. But Neil Watson, oh, he's doing it easy out there. Peter Bodger going down the back straightaway in the EH. He's putting it pretty well with Sheila Calderwood. Then we've got Ann Golding up there in the Cortina. Dean Sparrow in his car from Mark Bunning. Then we've got Steve Ellis, Jim English, Sean Quayle, Robert Sellers, and Chris Overall. Neil Watson doing it out there in the 40 car from Peter Bodger. Then we've got Sheila Calderwood, Ann Golding up there in 77. Dean Sparrow goes round her in the Tirana. Mark Bunning up there on the Boiling Valiant. And Peter Bodger doing it pretty well up there in the EH. And Sean Quayle calls it a night. So we're looking for the red car of Neil Watson. Here it comes, around again. So Neil Watson, he's got a good lead on this from the EH of Peter Bodger. Then we've got Sheila Calderwood, Dean Sparrow up there in 8. And Goldie hanging on in 77, from Mark Money in 72 on the outside, and Steve Ellis going around there now. And Jim English moving up in the Cortina. So still Watson the lead car with two cars to go from Bodger. Then we've got Sheila Calderwood from Dean Sparrow. Mark Bunning, Steve Ellis, Jim English, Chris Overall. Here's the last lap to go for Neil Watson in the 40 car. And Bodger in his car from Sheila Calderwood and Dean Sparrow. And there's the flag coming out for Neil Watson in Hamilton 40. Followed home by Peter Bodger in the and Sheila Calderwood in Portland 13. So another good win there to Whoppy. So in the 10 lap consolation to Neil Watson, good drive there. As I said, unusual for Neil not to be running in the feature, but no doubt he'll be back for the Vera Regan trophy event and the 50 lapper. Right, well, just the limit's 40 to go. It's 11:15. We're a little bit later than we intended to be. We've had a few problems tonight. Yep. Pretty quickly tonight, or seems to have. I say we had some stoppages which were beyond our control.
Which one?
But I think the racing's been pretty good. 15 left. Up there at 76. just as they come round in the limited sport and the feature here. It's Rob Tucker from Les Muck in the 69 car. Henry in 36 is much the way they've been all night. 17 the car of Garden, 10 the car of Thorn. Peter Worthy up there in 38 from Tim Watterson. Just watch the duel up the front here between Rob Tucker and Les Muck there. There's the top drivers. So we've got a pretty good field and we've lost two more lights. Well, it's certainly dark down there on this bottom corner. Alright, well there's another phase out and I think that's going to be the end of it, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we've had this slight problem again tonight, so that's it for tonight. That's it for tonight. We've had to declare the race.